Hey everybody, the Bong is here, ready to give you a brand new Let's Play! Super Mario World Master Quest 8, The Final Quest, a Super Mario World ROM hack, and this is brought to you by GameAnyone.com. I have seen some of the Super Mario World Master Quest ROM hacks, which is basically a series, and I think 8th truly is the last one, unless this guy changes his mind and puts out a 9th. Which, you know, I've never played the other Master Quest games, and not all of them are found available. So why don't we just go straight to the 8th one, because why not? Mario has been locked out from his house. The key to open the door is lost. Mario's quest is to find the key to open the door. Rather than just, I don't know, use a hammer? Or try to go up through the chimney? Does this guy even have a chimney? No. Switch Palace are in 11235574. Good luck to find them. I'm pretty sure English is not a first language for this guy. I'm just gonna say that much. Also, I think I should have waited so I can actually get a flower. Do I really need a flower? I don't know. Wait a minute. Hold on. Could I actually just get as many lives as I want? Because it seems like I should be able to. Huh. Apparently I don't even need to try to get a lot of lives here. I can just keep going to that stage over and over. Well, there's Yoshi's house. Do you have any trouble getting into your house? Hello! Sorry I'm not home, but I've got to rescue my friends who were captured by Bowser. They kept it exactly the same, even though the background is different. I like that little echo, even though we're outdoors. Okay, so apparently the Switch Palace is found in this level, but I don't know where. But I think I might have a good idea where to look first. And that was not it. Okay. Fair enough. Just in case it is somewhere I have to fly, I want to make sure I keep my cape. So I'm going to do whatever it takes to keep it. And that means swapping out if I have to. I don't want another flower. I already have one. Alright, so it has been a little bit of a while since I did a hack, so I figured why not just get back into it. Because yesterday, I finished Porky Pig's Haunted Holiday. Well, yesterday, for like videos that are being published, I mean, technically, I did finish it yesterday, even though I'm recording this on a Sunday. And the final video is up today. Again, from the day I'm recording this. By the time you guys are seeing this, that would have been, well, yesterday. I don't want to confuse you guys, okay? I'm just going to say that much. Because I've said too much. Aw, I missed. I tried. Ooh, okay, don't get hit there. To see if I can find the Switch Palace on the first try, as opposed to having to try harder. Whoa, whoa, okay. It's getting a little too crowded. I don't know why I'm checking for, like, invisible walls or anything. I'm not playing Super Mario Odyssey. I really should be playing that again, but my Joy-Cons are running out of juice, so I have to, like, charge them for a little while. I'll just give it a little bit of time. Been really enjoying it so far. And I'm running low on time on this level. I don't know if there's any value for getting all the Yoshi coins in this game, as, you know, other than possibly getting a life. Not up here. Alright. In the pipe, no? Huh, weird. I didn't see anything that was connected to a Switch Palace in any way. And I looked just about everywhere. Unless I read it wrong. Hang on. Yeah, 1-1. Okay, yeah, it is in 1-1. Let me go back to it just to be sure. I'm just gonna keep flying up. Just in case there is, like, an invisible area, so to speak. I don't see why a vine needs to be there if I can easily fly up there myself. And that's not a clue of anything. I'll just look around, and if I'm running low on time, I'll just start and select. Ipso facto, right? Now, I don't think I noticed anything a little off. Get some running momentum, please. No, okay. I'll just rely on my own devices. I think I might be able to fly up here. There we go. Anything out of the ordinary? Nope. Okay. Doesn't look like it's high up or anything. Oh, wait a minute, it's right here! Okay, first off, how the hell am I gonna get up there? This looks like it's a little tricky to do. I'm just being completely honest here. Oh, wait a minute. Invisible blocks. How would I have known to check up here, then? This really is a master quest. Like, that is just so out there. But anyway, that's the first palace, finally. Hopefully they're not all this complicated. Because we haven't been able to get to, like, the second level in, like, 8 minutes. Alright, let's go to 1-2. Oh, invisible block over here. Why do I have a feeling that this hacker... Well, ROM hacker, not actual hacker. Or maybe he is, I don't know. I don't follow his life. But, how would anyone know to just check up there for an invisible block? It's just so inconspicuous. Wow, lots of Yoshi's Island sound effects here. Even though this tile set over here that I'm standing on is from, like, the DS games. Or the DS game, rather. Like New Super Mario Brothers. In case I just needed to be clear. Even the pipes are from that game, too. Weird. Oh, made a little random fart noise. I guess that sometimes happens when the sound effects are incompatible, so to speak. Wow. Haven't run into too many issues until that happened. But I wouldn't really consider that much of an issue. Like a first Super Mario World problem, rather. Yeah, I think I'll just stick to the high road. Lots of charging chucks in this stretch. Strangely enough. Yeah, you just get one-ups for these. Now, are there checkpoints in the levels? Because I did not see any, mid-goal tape or anything. Okay, this looks pretty cool. Not gonna lie there. Huh, there's even a flag. Interesting. Hopefully there's a lot more, you know, classic-themed levels. 1-3, let's go. Hackers really loving this Donkey Kong Country 2 music. Sticker Brush Symphony. Figured I just need to enunciate that a little bit better. My enunciation is not always the best. If I can be completely honest here. I should say, like, completely honest. Here, and that was dickish. I don't care what anyone says, that was very lame. I'm keeping that death in, I'm sorry. Okay, I just want to see if that piranha plant would pop up, even if I was just right next to the pipe. Sometimes they'll do that. I mean, I've learned from lost levels. Usually plays Luigi. That tends to work. Like, some guys can actually beat lost levels as Mario, and for that I applaud you. But even though he's slippery, Luigi's got the better jumping height. And usually for long stretches, Luigi, for your high, you know, high jumps is better. Otherwise, you gotta make sure that you jump off an enemy that you have to see from almost off screen. Good luck to you on that one. I just really hope they don't put any more invisible blocks in the worst spots, like last time. Just one death is not a bad blemish on my record there. Hopefully I can keep it at one death. Because I don't know if there's any checkpoints, like I said before. Once I die really far into a stage, we'll find out. And it'll probably break my heart in the worst kind of way. But there's another stage clear. Hardly any secret exits. Maybe they make up for it by putting, like, Switch Palaces inside the levels? Perhaps that's what they're doing with it. Fog is a little distracting. Well, it's not really much of fog. It's like very thick clouds. Makes you think it's gonna cover up something, even though it won't. Oh god, from Super Mario 64, really? Well, if I got invincibility time, might as well use it. Ignore everything, and... Oh, that's all. And we go straight to the castle. Cool. Number one castle. I don't see what's so special about it to make it number one. Oh, almost made a bad play there. Whoa! Low ceilings! That definitely does not make it number one in my book. I would give it a 7. Well, there are mid-goal tapes. Maybe they're only in the fortresses, though. There's lots of grinders here. Gotta be careful with those. Not to mention, they're just gonna make a lot of noise. Aww. That's alright. Live and learn. Fire sticks are moving a little fast. Good thing they put that little pocket there. Getting a little bit worried. What? Oh, the door has to be all the way up? Huh, that does not count, okay. Oh, that sucked. I could have been able to fit through that door, and I bet you it was one of those doors you can actually push to open. So the logic even makes even less sense. It doesn't look like a pull door, there's no handle. Wait, you're not Iggy. Why am I fighting Birdo? Or Ostro? We'll just say it's Birdo. And there we go. First castle cleared already. Mario defeated Birdo in Castle 1. The key is in another castle. Did you find the yellow switch? Okay, so it is Birdo. Key is in another castle, whatever. Found the yellow switch, yes. There's the overworld. Well, 6 is over there. 5 is over there in some kind of forest. Well, I think I just came from a forest. Lots of fortresses, I'm noticing. There's 4. And 2 is just over there. 2 also has a fortress. Let me go back to the house because I need to remember where the other switch palaces were. 2-3 is the next one. Alright. And after that, I don't have to worry about another switch palace until World 5. A long stretch, I must say. Okay, you can't start and select your way out of the house. I mean, to be fair, you can just come out from either side. Okay, this looks cool. You're just popping out of a castle. Oh, is this like a remake of a 7-1 in Super Mario Bros. 1? That's pretty cool. Even though I can't get on that pipe. Maybe it wasn't this pipe you can go down, but... yeah, it's this one. Oh, even like the coin trove is the same. What is that background from? Is that from a Metroid Zero mission? I feel like it is. There's gotta be more to it than just this. Nope, that is all! Oh, I lost my cape. Bit of a bad play on my part. Oh, there are secret exits. Alright, let's go to 2-2. This is not a remake of anything. Okay, well, there's a little bit of a 1-2 from Mario 1. But not much. Oh, even the 1-up's in the same spot. Wait a minute. Are they taking elements from like 1-2 and 4-2? Like, almost like a remix? Oh, hold on. I need to find a key. Let me deal with the secret exit later. So the secret exit does not involve just going past the main pipe or anything. Duly noted, I guess. Two ghost house. Is that technically 2-3? I don't think so. Alright, so now I have to look for where a key could be located. Oh. I thought a star would be around there. Maybe that's a different block. You know what would be a very mean thing to do? Just put the key in one of the random brick blocks. And you have to literally guess where it is. That would suck. Not to mention you have to go up and retrieve it. That's not fun either. Worse yet, the blocks down at the bottom you have to use a buzzy beetle to break under. Okay, let's see. Might as well get these schmucks killed. That's not where the key is. Doesn't seem that obvious to me where the key would be. Unless it's here, no? I'm confused. Where, oh where, could this key be? Oh where could it be? Nope, not up that pipe. Is there a pipe I could go down? Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. I don't think I opened this. Okay. I would have hated for that to be where to go because I don't think I've been able to make it. Nah, they couldn't put the key in one of those blocks. Nope. It's not in here. I'm not seeing it. I didn't know you can, like, spin jump on these blocks. Hopefully I don't have to, because I'm running low on time. Oh god, I'm gonna die. Unless I just cancel out. Yeah, I'm gonna have to. Let me go get a cape. That way I can deal with these blocks if I have to. That's actually a well-hidden key. So I couldn't notice it right away. And usually I have a penchant for finding secret exits pretty easily. So far, I have no leads. Try to destroy many blocks as I can, because I might have to. Nope, not those blocks either. Do you guys have an idea? Or am I gonna have to look this up on YouTube or something? Cause right now, It's not looking as obvious as I thought it would be, or I hoped it would be. Hey, you think you'd be able to get up there, but apparently you can't. Do I have to be small, though? Let's see. Oh, okay. I don't like that Koopa being there. Nope. That doesn't work. Please tell me they didn't put it in an invisible block. Because that would be very sketchy. Very, very sketchy. Imagine if the invisible block is just right above the keyhole. Just be an absolute tool. You know what? I'm gonna have to look up this on my own. Give me a moment. Okay, I'm back. I found out where it was too. And it has a bit of bad news. In fact, I gotta go all the way back to the left. Thankfully, not too far. Like, literally up to here. Yeah. There was an invisible block and a P-switch right over there. How the hell I was supposed to know that is anyone's guess. But that was even meaner than where the Switch Palace was. Jeez, that's just awful. Why would you have that there? Like, I understand Master Quest, but that takes the cake. Oh, you just go straight to 2-5. I don't want to do that yet. I think we're going to wait till the next episode before we do the Ghost House, okay? Thanks for watching. See you next time.